So this is how you get your map into StraboSpot and then into the field. So this is the map we're working with, and what we need is something in a GeoTIFF format. So that's a georeferenced TIFF, and it could be any raster image. If yours isn't a TIFF or if it isn't georeferenced, I'll show you how to fix both of those things in another video. So here we're working with this map, and it's ready to go. So we're going to want it to be in a GeoTIFF, so that's a georeferenced TIFF. And it's going to be up to a gig in size, a gigabyte. And ideally, we're going to be working in WGS 84. So to add a map, this is the StraboSpot website. So I'm here on straboSpot.org, and I'm signed into my account. If you're not signed into your account, you'll have to sign in, and you'll see all of these options. Under the account header, we're going to click My Maps, Add New Map over here, and then we select File. So it'll ask you to upload it. I picked this one because it's relatively small in size, so this should go pretty fast. And there it is in StraboSpot. It'll show you a little preview. So here we're looking at the canopy cover. It'll show you a preview of where it is in the world so you can make sure it's located correctly. And if it's not, the other video will show you how to fix that as well. So what we need here is this code. So we'll copy that. But if you go under account My Maps again, it exists here, and this is where it lives now. So you can always have this code on hand. So now we're going to switch over to my iPad, the tablet, and I'm going to show you how to put the map into the tablet and download them so you can use them out in the field. So now we're looking at my iPad screen. I have StraboSpot loaded up. This is just the satellite we're looking at in the background, and I have this blank project. So to get our map in here after we've uploaded it to the website, we're going to click, and you can't see where I'm tapping, but I'm tapping the home button in the top left there. So that button that just turned blue in the corner, and opens up this side panel. Now under the maps heading, we're going to click Custom Maps right there, and we're going to tap on Add New Custom Map. So we're going to give it a title. In this case, I'll just call it Canopy Cover. Great. And then here we're going to tap StraboSpot My Maps right there. And so here it requires the Strabo My Maps ID. So that will be that code from before. Bit awkward that the keyboard covers it up, but I have that in front of me and I'm just going to type that in. So for me, that was 668 EA 1B. And of course, your code is going to be different to mine. Unless you want to download this map as well, then you can put in this code. And that's how you can share your map with other people. So if you give somebody else your code for your map, they'll be able to download it to their project as well. So there's my code, and I just tap on Save. So this is importing it as a base map. So now it's saved, and it should live under here. So what I'm tapping right now is the layers icon. So we have our three dots, we have the star and the layers icon under that. I tap that, and then under Custom Base Maps, I can see Canopy Cover. So if I click that, it'll get rid of the satellite base map, and it'll show me my custom base map. And this is the one we've uploaded. So we're in the field in this area. We'll get to see our little blue dot or GPS walking around on this map. So right now, this works because we're in online mode. The tablet is connected to the internet and it's able to load in the map. When we're out in the field, we're probably going to be offline. So what we're going to want to do is download this map for offline use. To do that, on the left here, I'm going to tap the three dots. So those are the three dots on top of the star. And there's the option here to save map for offline use. So the tablet will save whatever is on the screen at the moment. So because I have this on the screen, it'll save everything there for offline use. If I zoom into just this part of the map as an example, it will only save this part for offline use. So depending on how, if you want to save the whole map, you'll need to either zoom out to get the entire map on the screen, or you can do it in multiple batches depending on how detailed you want it. So when we go save map for offline use, it'll ask us our max zoom level. So that's how detailed we want to be. If you look here in the bottom corner, bottom left corner, you'll see it says zoom 12.6. So this is what it looks like under a zoom level of about 13. This is what it looks like under 15. So for my map, this one in particular, it's not very high in resolution. So I'm not really benefiting much from downloading at a much higher zoom level. So for this, I might keep it at around 15. So for that, I'll get the whole map in one go, the three dots, save map for offline use, and 15 will do. So that's only 175 tiles, that'll download quickly. But as you can see, when we increase the zoom level, the number of tiles starts to grow. Usually downloading a lot of tiles, it could be slow or it could fail. So if you do want to get it really detailed, I would recommend zooming into a portion of your map and then possibly downloading it in batches instead of in one go. And another thing to show here, if you want to go beyond 18, all you need to do is zoom in more. So now that we're zoomed in more, it'll show us higher numbers that we can download at. So for now, let's go to 18. Let's go and download a 15. Let's grab the entire map. Let's save the map for offline use. And 15 will do. So here it just starts the download. And usually this doesn't take too long, but because this is a live recording, odds are it'll take longer than it ever has. Yep, there we go, we're done. So now, this should work when we're offline as well. Let's test that real quick. Let's go here, and let's go straight into airplane mode with the Wi-Fi off. So now we're fully offline, but we can still see the map. And if your iPad has GPS with a SIM card slot, then you'll be able to see yourself on this map even when you're offline. You can do the same for the satellite maps. You can download them for offline use, or the topo maps that come built in with StraboSpot.